exist, you deserve to exist. And if you deserve to exist, you deserve to be who you are as fully as you possibly can.
There is no way to peace. Peace is the way. Peace is every step.
We are actually in a period of global spiritual emergency. And I want to really stress that that's a positive thing.
You are here for a reason, to be yourself expressed in fullness and in love.
I am you. You are me. There's only one of us here. Why would I want to hurt myself?
Well, I think love is the fabric of everything.
Hi, and I'm another version of you. And with that, we begin the Waking Universe. And today, we are talking about destiny. And we're talking about what it means to create your own life, like what it means to find who you are. And I think there's a lot of tools that you can use to do that, one of which is called numerology. And frankly, I don't know a whole lot about numerology. It intrigues me. You know, it's basically the fact that numbers can tell you something about your life and who you are. It's been around for thousands of years, but again, I'm not going to go into it because I don't know enough about it, but I'm here with someone who actually does know quite a bit about it, and that is Ms. Ronda MacNeil, and it is very nice to have you in the studio today. Hi, Ronda.
Great to be here.
What is numerology? Like, what is this that you work with? Because you are a numerologist, right?
Right, yes. Mm-hmm. What I do is I use the birth date. With numerology. Mm-hmm. Our birth date, we're all given our birth date for a specific reason, and when those numbers are added up, it's what our soul is here to learn. Mm-hmm. It's our life path number, mm-hmm. our life purpose number. And it helps us to understand ourselves better, and it can help us understand the people in our lives as well.
What can someone learn from numerology?
We can understand why we do the things we do. Some people have, it's kind of like people want things better in their life. And mm-hmm. when we look at when we add up our numbers, we can see where somebody might have issues with communication, with stability in their life, with finding acceptance for themselves and acceptance for others, about understanding about abundance and power. And our intuition as well.
So let's talk a little bit about your journey with numerology.
Numbers actually first started coming to me several years ago when I was, I would just wake up and see the same number on the clock every morning. And so I thought, well, there's got to be some significance to this. And I received some books, and that helped me to understand what those numbers meant. And further down on my through my life, I came across a time in my life where everything changed for me, and I became very confused. I didn't know what I was supposed to do with my life, and a very important book came to me, and it was about your life path numbers. Mm-hmm. And
is this it right here?
Yes.
This is The Life You Were Born to Live by Dan Millman. I've actually interviewed Dan, and he's a really, really interesting guy. And
yeah.
So what was it about this book that got to you?
Well, as you can see, it's full of bookmarks. And I have I started reading about myself after I added up my birth date, and I found out what I'm supposed to achieve for my soul. And it helped me understand myself so much. It was like, okay, I got to put this to a little bit of a test. And so I started to make a list of all my family. Dan suggested to do that so that you could understand others too, and that also helps you understand yourself. Mm-hmm. And so I got all my relatives, all my family's birth dates, and I really started to understand them, why things affected them the way that it did. And the more I learned, it was like the more I wanted to learn.
What is Dan's philosophy in his book that led you to that? Like, how does he say all this stuff works, and how do you think numerology works?
I think it works. Well, numerology has been around for over 2,500 years, but it's a science like astrology.
Would you say that it's like feng shui? Or I know that like in China, numbers are very important. And
right.
Is that numerology? Mm-hmm. Are they practicing the same thing?
In a roundabout ways, different mm-hmm. cultures relate to the numbers in different ways. Some cultures, the four is actually not a very good number. you know, but in numerology, it's about stability.
What about this whole Western notion that 13 is an unlucky number,
right.
You know, 666 is an unlucky number, but yet I find in China, because I met somebody from China once and they were talking about numbers and they said, well, in China, 13 is like the luckiest number.
Yeah.
And six is like one of the luckiest numbers. You know, so why is it that we have these different kind of cultural understanding of numbers?
You know, it's that everyone relates to the numbers differently. For in spirituality, the 666 is about having a balance between the material and the spiritual world.
Mm-hmm.
The 13, for me, is a very lucky number.
Mm-hmm.
For some, it's kind of like taboo. It just depends on the way that you're raised and family, genetics, history.
Well, yeah, I mean, I know even most buildings don't have a 13th floor.
True, yeah.
Yeah. So, go figure.
Yeah.
So you were saying you were at a point in your life where you were struggling.
Mm-hmm.
And what did numerology, you know, do to change that? And how did that work?
It helped me to understand what I'm here to do. I'm about creativity and confidence, and confidence wasn't something that I comes easily for me.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a lot of, I don't know,
a lot of courage.
Yes, a lot of courage to build up that confidence, yes. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's a matter of finding it and creativity, too. You know, I'm an artist, and I'm also going to school for graphic arts, but at that time, well, I did know what my life path number is for the creativity, and it's a matter of finding the confidence to put it out there
mm-hmm.
and share it with others. And so that's helped teach me a lot, helped me to establish myself with the numerology, helping others with the numerology, giving the numerology readings, and being where I'm at today.
Let's talk a little bit more about numerology and how it has an effect on being able to learn more about your world. You know, I've always seen it as something that's very kind of mysterious and very sort of just kind of out there in terms of, you know, there may be something to it, but it seems like nobody really understands, you know, how it works. The Chinese, like I said, have beliefs in it. I'm sure a lot of other cultures have, you know, beyond them. What's your take on it?
What's my take on it? You know, each number has its own vibration, mm-hmm. its own energy, and its own meaning. And when we take the birthday and we add it up, the month and the day, when those two are added up, adds up to the attitude number.
Mm-hmm.
And then when we add up the year into it.
Okay, wait, let's see. So if mm-hmm. you take the birthday and the year?
And the month.
And the month. The birthday mm-hmm. and the month, that becomes an attitude number.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a matter of how we project ourselves to others.
Mm-hmm.
Say a five energy, mm-hmm. a five attitude would be very fun, very outgoing. They love adventure. They're going to have adventure in their life.
Mm-hmm. So if my birthday was January 1st, 1990,
mm-hmm.
you know, then I would add up all of those numbers and mm-hmm. make one number.
Right.
Okay, so a five is what?
About adventure.
Adventure. Okay, so what do the other numbers mean that could potentially be?
Say the month and the date, that adds up to the attitude number, and then when we add up the year to it too, mm-hmm. that will add up to two numbers.
Mm-hmm.
Those two numbers are like stepping stones. Those have significance in our life, but then when those two numbers are added up together, that becomes the life path number,
mm-hmm.
and that's our main goal, is to achieve that energy through our soul.
Mm-hmm.
That's sometimes we're so focused on the stepping stones that we don't get to our life path number working in those energies until later on in life.
Hmm. If someone sitting at home goes and does that and adds it mm-hmm. up, what are the significance of some of the different numbers? Like, what do the numbers actually mean?
Well, like one is creativity and confidence.
Mm-hmm.
So a person that works the one energy is here to create, allow their creative energies to flow, mm-hmm. and find their confidence to share it. The two is about cooperation and balance, finding being able to say no when it's necessary.
Mm-hmm.
A two energy, if they're taking care of everyone else's needs and desires and neglect their own, it'll have a tendency to shut them down, and they'll start to resent those that are taking advantage of them.
Mm.
So it's important that they say no. It's important that they give. If they become so closed off to giving, they become very lonely.
Mm-hmm.
And then they find themselves with no one around them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so, and then the three?
The three is about expression and sensitivity. those working the three energy are here to learn to express their feelings and help others understand through understanding how themselves, how they feel, so mm-hmm. that they can help others understand.
So a three is a very empathic type number?
It is, yeah. Mm-hmm. They're very sensitive, and threes have the ability to absorb other people's feelings. Mm-hmm. And if they're not aware of it, it can be very confusing. Mm. Their moods change instantly, and if they're not, and if they don't know why, they can have a very difficult time shaking it.
Okay, and then a four?
A four is about stability and process. Mm-hmm. A four is here to, they just want to reach the summit. I mean, they don't want to take the proper steps day by day. They want to accomplish everything overnight. And a four's got to take a deep breath and realize it's about the journey and not the summit.
And again, this is the life path number. So this is what you mm-hmm. get when you add up the birthday, the month, and the year. And then you ultimately come to like a single digit number.
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. There is the master numbers. Mm-hmm. But you know, you can have a three and a two for your stepping stones. So you will work through those energies first, and then the three and the two will add up to a five. Mm-hmm. So basically you'll be working through the cooperation and balance, the expression and sensitivity, and then go into the freedom and discipline. Hmm.
Okay, so we talked about a four, right? Mm-hmm. And then so in the five is what?
Five is freedom and discipline.
Okay, freedom and discipline. So somebody's that's all about I want to be carefree and don't have any worries, but I need to balance that with having the discipline to get the laundry done on time.
Absolutely.
And pay my bills. And you know,
yeah.
I wonder if that's me. Okay, and then a six?
A six is about vision and acceptance. Mm-hmm. Sixes are visionaries, and they can see things a lot differently than others. And mm-hmm. if they're not aware of it, then it can be confusing too. They've got to find patience to help others see things the way that they see it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And let's say does someone ever start out as a five and become a six or change? Or like, I mean, is this just like a basic personality type?
Like attitude?
Yeah.
For the attitude? The attitude number, that usually, with the day and the month, that will add up to, if it adds up to an 11, then that 11 would add up to a two. Mm. Mm-hmm. So, but pretty much the attitude number always adds up to be one number.
Okay.
For the life path number, the life path number can add up to a 10, mm-hmm. an 11, or a 12. Mm-hmm. And if it adds up to an 11, the zero has significance. It's about inner gifts. Mm-hmm. There are master numbers, 11, 22, 33, 44, 55. Those are master numbers. Mm-hmm. So you wouldn't add those two together as being the life path number. Mm.
Okay, so if you don't mind, let's go down. This is really mm-hmm. interesting. So let's go down the rest of the numbers. So we talked about a six. Mm-hmm. What about a seven? Like, what if someone adds up to a seven? What does that mean?
The seven is about trust and openness. Mm-hmm. And sevens are here to open up doors. If they experience past from a painful experience, their mind will shut it down and say, no, I'm not going to do that again because I got hurt before. Mm. So they've got to trust themselves to know that not every experience is going to end in the same way and open up the doors, go through those doors.
Okay, an eight?
An eight is about abundance and power. Mm-hmm. So eights are here to balance their inner strength, not give it away and not abuse it. Mm. So it's a matter of always remembering that for them, that love and approval come unconditionally and not try and control people either.
I have no idea how you even remember all of this. I mean, it's very, very, it's a lot of technique and I'm sure craft and understanding like how these work. Nine? How high up does this go? Does it go to 10 or?
It goes to the 10, to the zero.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, mm-hmm. And so the nine is about integrity and wisdom. Mm-hmm. Nines are old souls. Mm-hmm. They bring a lot of wisdom with them in to this lifetime through their past lives, mm-hmm. and honesty plays a very important role for them.
Mm. So then the next one would be a zero.
The zero.
So like mm-hmm. if you have like a if your day and year add up to you know, and then you total everything and it comes up to a how do you get a zero?
Like you get a zero. It would be either the zero would be in the 10.
Mm. Oh, okay.
So if you had a 28, mm-hmm. 28 mm-hmm. would add up to a 10. Mm-hmm. Or if you're whole year, the month, the day, and the year added up all together, it would add up to either a 2020, mm-hmm. 30, which would be the 30, mm-hmm. and then that would add up to the 3 or the 2, mm-hmm. you know, or the 404, mm-hmm. and pretty much that's where the 0 is either in one of the stepping stones or in the 10 with the life path number.
Hmm. So I know that a lot of people say that, like you mentioned earlier, that you saw numbers, like mm-hmm. you kept seeing repeats of the same numbers, and that led you to numerology.
Right.
I know a lot of people will wake up and they'll see like 11:11 or 22:22 or something like that. What's the significance of that? And is there certain numbers like 11:11? If that's the number that you keep seeing, is that different than seeing 22:22 or 7:48 in the morning or whatever? Like how? What does all that mean? Because a lot of people think like, well, that's just your brain playing tricks on you, or maybe there's some deep significance to this, but they don't know what it is.
Well, you know, we are directed in so many ways through our subconscious that we're not fully aware of it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when we automatically open our eyes and see those numbers, it's kind of like, you know, pay attention at that time, especially the 11, mm-hmm. 11, 11.
Yeah, I do notice that sometimes I'll just be working or something and I'll tend to look up at the clock and it's 11, mm-hmm. 11. And I'll go, oh, okay, well, there's 11, 11 again. You know, and I don't know, maybe I'm looking up other times and just not noticing it, but because of the 11, 11 I am, I don't know. But what does that mean? Like if I see 11, 11.
11:11 is what are you thinking at that very moment? Mm-hmm. If you wake up and see it, it's a matter of paying attention to your dreams. Mm-hmm. Do you recall anything from your dream at that time? Mm-hmm. If when we're conscious, when we're working or doing our daily routine, when we see it on the clock, it's like pay extra close attention to what you're thinking at that very moment. If you're worried, if you're concerned about something, it's very important that you clear it and cancel it and turn it into a thought about something that you're grateful for or something that you desire, because that's how we manifest.
Hmm. Interesting. So you're saying that, and this brings me to another point. So you're saying mm-hmm. that like that seeing these numbers is just kind of like a wake-up call to just say, hey, pay attention to your thoughts.
Right.
And you're saying that, okay, so your thoughts manifest energy, like, you know, because your thoughts, you know, any psychologist will tell you, if you keep thinking about something, you're probably going to make it happen.
Right.
So that brings me to another point, which is, how does this work? Like, do I have like a big like 11:11 or something stamped on my forehead for my whole life because these are the numbers and the way they add up, and so that means, well, sorry, this is the way your life's going to go, you know, or like, you know, like where does free will come into this?
Well, you know, we all have a choice, mm-hmm. and we choose how we think. Mm-hmm. And if we don't like what's happening in our life, we need to choose how we're thinking about what's happening in our life. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like how we react to our circumstances brings about our reality. Mm. And so if things are not going well in our life, we need to look at where we can change our thoughts about how we're seeing how things are happening in our life to more positive way of feeling about it and a positive way of thinking about it, and things have a magical way of transforming and turning into better and better and better. The more positive we think about it, the more positive things happen.
Hmm. And so the numbers are just giving you a starting point and not an end point. So because they're just kind of saying, here's the kind of the mix of ingredients that you're dealing with,
the
right?
Basics for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a starting point. Mm-hmm. The numbers though are infinity. There's no end to the numbers. Mm-hmm. And there will never be an end to the time that you may see that on the clock. Mm-hmm. You know, 10 years from now, you could look at the clock and there it's going to be, mm-hmm. you know, and it still is going to mean the same thing, mm-hmm. about paying attention to your thoughts. The 22, the 22, that is about trusting that everything's going to work itself out, mm-hmm. that everything happens for a reason, and it's a matter of finding the good in all of it, because there is sometimes, you know, when we have a major accident, it's like, what good is there in that? Mm-hmm. But, you know, at that time, everything does happen for a reason. So when we find the good in it and take that good from it, then we can... we live happier in our life. We're not full of regrets, we're not full of resentments, and we're not weighted down by being a victim.
So That's fascinating, and it's a beautiful way of looking at it. I mean, I really do. I think that's like a very beautiful way of, and I never thought about it that way, you know, in terms of it's just very reassuring, you know, when you see something like that. But my question is, who invented the idea of like, I know, when you see a 2222, you're going to think about being grateful for, you know, what you have, or, you know, or whatever it is, you know, or when you see a zero, ooh, watch out, you know, like who came up with this? How do you interpret it to mean this?
The Scientology of it, pretty much. You know, it's like astrology. It is a science. Who come up with the formula, I am not aware of, but every person that I've studied has the same definition for each number.
So this is not just like what Rhonda thinks.
No,
this is what pretty much is like an industry standard, I guess.
Yeah, several teachers that I have studied, because it's not just from one person that I've learned what the numbers mean. There's been several teachers. One, I have learned what the master numbers are.
So what are the master numbers again?
11, 22, 33, 44, 55, 66.
And what does that mean, the master numbers?
The master numbers is it's like there's two energies per that number. It's a significant, it's like it's twin. There's more to it. It's like more reinforced. So
it's like double the energy.
Double the energy.
Okay, so if I'm like an 11, and 11 means creativity?
Creativity and confidence.
So if I have 11, what does that mean? I'm like an egomaniac?
You're extremely creative.
Extremely creative, okay.
Extremely creative.
Okay.
Yeah.
And a 22?
A 22 is a master builder.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and a 33 is a master humanitarian. Master builder, they have the ability to build anything in their life that they desire.
So like a master manifester or a master builder, like literally like I'm taking a hammer and building something.
You know, they can be extremely handy with their hands and a master manifester at the same time, you know. 33, with a true humanitarian, whatever they do in their life affects many people. And so they may never be fully aware of it. It's just a matter of, are they affecting them in a good way? Are they putting out that positive energy? Are they working in a negative way? Because any way that they're working it, it's going to affect many people. And they may never, ever be fully aware of it.
Okay. And was it 44?
44 is a master healer.
So master healer. So, and if I was just a 4, what's the difference again?
Stability and process.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah. So, but why does a double 4 become a healer versus a single 4 is the stability and process?
A 44 is just, it's a double stability, you know. So a healers, they are very stable. They're very grounded. They're very in tune to themselves. And so, and they're able to make choices, and they make, they trust their intuition. And they have a gift. The 44 with the master healer is just, it's a gift within them.
Okay.
So.
And then the 55?
It's a master change.
A master change.
Master changes.
What does that mean?
That just, the 5 is all about changes. You know, the 5 is about adventure, which is always about changes. You know, it's a matter of being disciplined to, you know, like you said, get things accomplished because they can be a little scattered at time. So a 5 is just about changes.
And then changes. The 66?
It's about balancing the spiritual with the material.
Okay. And if it was just a 6 and not a 66, it's what
it's
then?
The vision and acceptance.
So vision and acceptance is the visionary. It's like the Bill Gates. It's the, you know, that kind of person who had an idea and then enacted it. But if it's, but then the visionary, if you double it, then becomes?
About balancing the spiritual with the material.
Okay. So it's like you're transcending. So your vision becomes like you're just breaking open the whole thing and like seeing beyond the dimensions or something.
Yes.
Okay.
Pretty much. Yeah.
So can you think of an example of somebody who would be like a 66?
You know, not anybody that I have ever come in contact with has their birthday added up to a 66. They may be born on June 6th, which would put them at like with that 66 there together. But the highest that I have experienced with giving the numerology readings has been a 44, which would be a 448, 448. It goes a little higher than that, but that's the
So what day would somebody have to be born to be like a 66 or something? Like, I mean, why is that such a rare number to come up with?
It's because if you think about it, if the highest numbers is 9, mm-hmm. right? When you add up 9. So 1999 is the year that's the highest.
I see.
See? Mm-hmm. And then for the month would be September would be a 9. Mm-hmm. And 29 would be the highest for that month because you'd have the 2 and the 9 mm-hmm. that you add into it. So
So this is all really fascinating to me, mm-hmm. but I'm still trying to wrap my head around how this works. And I know you may not even know
I don't.
How it works, but it's one of those things where, I try to make the show about both the science of this and mm-hmm. the spirit of it, so that we can bring the two together so that someone sitting at home can go, I can see how that could work. Why is it that a number always adds up, the same, whether you're looking at it in one, in this person or that person?
That person. Yeah. Like identical twins, or even if they're not identical, twins are born on the same day, mm-hmm. and they're going to work the same life path numbers, but they're going to work it in their own way.
Well, that actually brings me to another point, mm-hmm. A skeptic would say, well, I know two people and they're born on the same day and they're totally different.
Yes.
And in astrology, okay, you can say, well, what minute and how does that work and everything, but can you get that accurate with numerology, as well?
Well, it's like, it's like yin and yang. Mm-hmm. There's odd and an even, like with the numbers, there's odd and even. Even though twins may work the same life path number, even all the way to the same attitude number, they work it differently. They will resonate to it differently. One twin may have a very easy time expressing their feelings, where the other one may have an extremely difficult, challenging time mm-hmm. expressing their feelings. So it's just a matter of how they relate to that energy. Mm.
And how can you tell how they relate to that energy via numerology? Like, how can you look at the numbers and tell the difference between the two personalities, even though they're twins?
Right. Mm-hmm. And, basically what I do is I explain to those that I give a reading to what the energies mean, and then they take it, interpret it, how they relate to that energy for themselves. Mm-hmm. I can tell kind of pretty much if somebody works a 2 attitude, excuse me, if they are a peacekeeper or a drama maker. Mm.
Okay, so I guess what you're saying is that it's not just the numbers, it's the person getting the numbers. It's the mm-hmm. interaction between the person and the numbers. So it's not like one number fits all. Again, so it's not like and that kind of brings me back to my earlier question of, it's like destiny versus fate. Like, if you can create your own destiny or just be resigned to a fate that you can't change.
Right.
You're interpreting for them, and then they're taking their own, they're creating it and making it what they want
what
to
they,
be.
Well, absolutely. Yeah. Because, someone that works the 2 number for cooperation and balance, and if they feel so consumed with everyone else's responsibilities and neglect their own, mm-hmm. then they're out of balance. Mm-hmm. But then there's those that work the 2 energy, and they're okay with saying no when they need to, and they don't neglect themselves, and they're very content with helping others, and others know excuse me, that they can rely on them when they need to, when it's necessary. Mm-hmm. So it's just, it's a matter of what way that we're working our energies. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So let's do a sample reading.
Okay.
I gave you my birthday before.
You did.
So let's. Okay. What did you come up with? Be gentle.
Okay. Well, you're a 24/6, and mm-hmm. you work a 5 attitude. So for the 5 attitude, adventure is very important for you.
And 5 attitude is again?
Freedom and discipline.
Freedom and discipline. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's 5 attitudes, 5 energy, whether it's in their attitude number or their life path number. Mm-hmm. It's kind of works about the same way. A 5 energy has a butterfly inside of them that wants to escape. Mm-hmm. And if they're not aware of that little yearning that they feel, it can get a little distracting. Mm-hmm. So if they feel like they're being squeezed into a box, they need to get out and just even go across town. Mm-hmm. They can find some adventure. Mm-hmm. They can become so enhanced in a movie or a book that that will become their adventure. But if they do not go out and seek adventure for themselves personally, then they feel restricted. So it's just very important that they not, you know, cage up their butterfly.
Okay.
Yeah.
And that, so that's the, so the 24 and the 6 mm-hmm. becomes a 5? How does that happen?
No, that was your, the 5 is how, with the month and the day that you were born.
Okay.
That's so, your attitude
I take
number.
The, first I take the month and the day and uh-huh. I add that up. So if it's like 4 and 7, you know, it's right. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
That would be 11.
Yeah, so and then that becomes the attitude number.
And actually okay. the 11 at that point would be added up to a 2 when it is with the, excuse me, with the attitude. Mm-hmm. It would be a 2.
Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But with it, with the life path number, it would stay at 11.
Okay. Okay. So what else about, okay. about mind now? So the 5 was the attitude number.
Attitude number. Okay. And the 2 is about cooperation and balance. Mm-hmm. So it's important for you to be able to say no when it's necessary. Mm-hmm. It's to keep yourself in balance. A 2 also teeters totters between their independent and codependent side. Mm-hmm. And they can get lost in a relationship if they conform too easily to others. Mm-hmm. They have a tendency to lose sight of themselves. Mm-hmm. So it's not selfish. They've just got to have some me time. Mm-hmm. They got to be able to stay acquainted with who they are.
Right.
Because they can definitely lose sight of who they are mm-hmm. in relationships and by over giving mm-hmm. to others. 4, because you're the 24-6, the 4 is about stability and process. Mm-hmm. So it's important that you slow down and not try and reach the summit too quickly. Hmm. It's when that happens, it's like skipping steps. It's like pulling a card from a house of cards. It all falls and you find yourself starting all over.
Okay.
And it can get quite frustrating. Mm-hmm. So it's a matter of 4 energy reminding themselves it's about the journey and not the summit. Mm. They also have, it can at times, not all 4s, it depends on their level, you know, of how they work it. But can have difficult times making choices, making decisions. Mm. But they have to trust their intuition and make a choice. And always remember that there's no wrong or right choice. It's about growing and developing. Hmm.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah, and a 4 also, if they're not comfortable with the choice that they made, they can sit and look at what they didn't do and focus more on what they didn't do. They lose sight of what they did do. Mm-hmm. And then they start to live with regrets. So it's a matter of, it's good to reflect, but not concentrate there. We can't right. change what we didn't do. Mm-hmm. So it's a matter of making a choice and focusing on what.
What's interesting is a lot of this sounds like me maybe at a younger age. Mm-hmm. You know, and so could you be tuning in because those dates have been the same since I was born, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do people change over time and then kind of overcome some of these things? I know
absolutely.
You were talking before, some of these are like stepladder numbers.
Yeah, they're stepping stones. They're, mm-hmm. Yeah, it is. You know, I mean, those that find stability, you know, with you, with your cooperation and balance, finding that balance point, mm-hmm. once you establish that, then stability starts to come more into play. Mm-hmm.
Right, balancing the freedom and
right.
Freedom and discipline.
And discipline.
Yeah,
yeah,
mm-hmm.
with your attitude.
Right.
Because that is what you project yourself to be, you know, that's who you are, mm-hmm. but that's how others see you. Mm. And then when they get to know you, they will start to see more of who you are, and that would be the 6 energy. Mm-hmm. And that's your life path number, and that's about vision and acceptance.
Mm, okay, and that means?
That you see things differently than others. Mm-hmm. That you've got to find patience to help others see how you see things.
Right, that's that, the Bill Gates thing.
Yes.
But,
yeah.
Okay, so how can that help me? Like knowing my number 6 or whatever, mm-hmm. how does that help me on my life path?
It helps you to accept yourself and accept others as well. Mm-hmm. You know, it helps you to also understand that you're here to develop patience mm. so that you can help others see things differently.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's really hurry this up. No,
okay.
I'm just kidding. so you're saying I'm here to help each other help other people see things differently.
Right.
Right. And But again, you're telling me this, but it's really up to me to interpret
how you take
how that works
to you.
In my life.
Yeah, I see. How it relates to you. Mm-hmm. A six energy has a little voice inside of them that says it could be better.
Mm-hmm. And that little, says it could be better.
It could be better.
Yeah,
everything
so I'm
could be
at
better.
It and going, yeah, this could be better. Yeah, that's
this
true.
Could be better.
That's very true.
And when you hear that little voice, it's important to quiet down and tell it everything's excellent the way that it is. Mm-hmm. There is no such thing as perfect, and excellence is the greatest that we can achieve. Mm-hmm. And so when they realize that, they're not as hard on themselves if things doesn't turn out the way that they intended it. Mm. Yeah, our subconscious leads us in a direction we're not fully aware of. Mm. And we have no control over the outcome of our choices. So it's a matter of finding acceptance for what we did choose, for that six energy, what they did choose, and accept themselves for the outcome and tell themselves it's just excellent, even if it didn't turn out how they intended it.
So have you seen this? I mean, obviously you have. You've seen this at work in people's lives. Mm-hmm. And do you have any stories that you want to share, or you know, like actual people that you've worked with that this has affected them in some way, or helped them to know you know, how numbers kind of line up?
Yeah, you know, if someone works the eight energy, and they're not aware of their inner strength, and know that love and approval come unconditionally, they will continually be submissive to people in their lives because they feel like, okay, well, I gotta keep doing this so that I can receive love and approval from someone. And then they lose sight of themselves, they become puppets. And I've, by helping giving readings and helping those that have that energy understand that they're here to harness that inner strength for themselves, then they start to become or take more control over their life, and gives them lots more strength, inner strength for themselves.
So, and or like if someone was a four, you know, and they're the four is that what was it again?
Stability and process.
And process. So if you said to someone who was extremely unstable, well, your life is all about learning stability.
Right.
You know, and then and that just helps them to step back away and look at themselves, maybe?
Absolutely. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, life is not supposed to be hard. Mm-hmm. You know, we make it a lot more challenging than what it has to be. Mm-hmm. And so when we understand what we're here to achieve through the numbers, what the energies that we're here to work through, it kind of helps us to stop and step back and reflect and say, wow, okay, you know, there is no such thing as a get-rich-quick scheme, and I gotta quit trying to reach for that. That overnight.
Yeah. Well, like, what would be the downside of someone, like, say, who's a one, like, who comes to a one, and, okay, I'm all about creativity, and process, did you say?
Content. Confidence.
Confidence, yeah. if a one is all about creativity and confidence, what's the downside to that? Like, for someone who's on their life path, and you can say, okay, well, you're all about creativity and confidence, because they start out without it, without the creativity and without the confidence, and that's their sort of their life goal or life path, would you say?
Well, it's always there. Mm-hmm. It's just having them be aware of it. A one, you know, with the creativity comes in many forms. It's not just in arts and music and writing, it's everything that we put out there. Mm-hmm. It's raising a family, gardening, cooking, work life, you know, and always the more positive creative energy we put out there, the more positive creative energy we receive. Mm-hmm. We either build or destroy, expand or contract in two key areas, and that's in our creativity and in our expression. Mm-hmm. So it's a matter of how we're working our energies. When we understand what our energies are, that one energy can say, oh, wow, I am here to create.
Again, talking about energy and the fact that, okay, if everything has an energy, everything has a vibration, including a number, and you know, if you take this kind of quantum concept that all things exist at the same time and time is just an illusion, really, then these numbers are somehow tapping into something that's more universal than just a number.
Absolutely.
You know, it's assigning a value to something that goes into a much more quantum state.
Yes.
You know, than linear. And so, can you do this with things besides just people?
Oh, yes. Yes, addresses.
Okay. So let's take the have the address here.
I do.
And that was a nice segue into that.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the studio. Like, what's the energy of the studio based upon the number that's in the address?
The studio address adds up to a 19.
Okay, I think we can say the studio address is 847.
Right.
So if I just take the first three numbers of my house or my address or my studio office, whatever, and I just add those numbers together. So 847 adds up to 19.
19.
And so what does that mean?
It adds up to a 19, and the 19 add up to a 10.
Okay, so the life process number would be the 10, and the attitude number would be the 19.
No,
right?
Actually, it wouldn't have an attitude number.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it would just be the stepping stones for the life path number.
Oh, okay.
The 19 would be the stepping stones
to get onto the life path.
Right.
Got it.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is that?
The one is about creativity, so it's very creative.
Okay.
And it's got creative energy around it.
That's good, because it's a studio. So.
It's a studio.
So thank goodness.
Yeah, a lot of creativity there, because it's in the stepping stones and it's also in the life path number.
Mm-hmm.
So it's double for it.
Okay.
So there's great significance with it.
Mm-hmm.
The confidence, the energy that comes from the studio to the people in the studio.
Mm-hmm.
All those that come to this place bring the confidence, which, you know, adds to that.
Well, yeah,
as
and,
well.
And you really can't step on camera unless you have a certain degree of confidence,
right.
I guess. Sometimes I have it, sometimes I don't, but that's that whole balance, you know.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah. And the 9 is about integrity and wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of wisdom that these walls hold,
mm-hmm.
you know. And so it's not kind of like random.
So wait, so 9 again means what?
Integrity and wisdom.
Integrity and wisdom.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so you're saying that there's a lot of integrity in this building.
A lot of integrity,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
So you might be here if there's an earthquake.
Yeah, this would be a very good place. Just don't be under light.
Yeah.
But yeah, there is. There's a lot of wisdom that comes with this address,
mm-hmm.
this structure, this building. And also, you know, it's a place to gather wisdom. This place projects a lot of wisdom
mm-hmm.
out as well.
Mm-hmm. I would like to agree with that.
Yeah,
so yeah,
it does.
And then. The 10?
Zero.
So the stepping stone numbers I'm looking at as, okay, so I've got creativity and I've got wisdom,
right.
basically.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've got creativity that's leading towards a lot of wise things, let's say.
Right.
Now, those are the stepping stones.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, those are things that we're working on towards the greater goal of the life path.
Right.
Okay, and the life path being that 10.
The 10.
But is that a 10 or a 0? Because I know at one point you said that 10 means 0.
Well, the 10, mm-hmm. the 1 has significance and so does the 0. So
okay.
they're each individual numbers, individual energies,
mm-hmm.
but it is a 10.
Okay.
So the 1 is, you know, creativity and confidence, so
mm-hmm.
that's why it's very significant
okay.
for this building.
Mm-hmm.
And the 0 is about inner gifts.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Interesting. Inner gifts. What does that mean?
The
zero in general means inner gifts.
Right.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what does zero, what does that mean, inner gifts?
What does it mean? You know, we all have these, but they develop over their own time, and there's 4 of them.
Mm-hmm.
The first one is intuition. So intuition is very strong in this area,
mm-hmm.
in this building.
Mm-hmm.
And valuing our own opinion. Everyone valuing their own opinion keeps that intuition very clear and very open.
Valuing our own opinion is part of those inner gifts. That's another inner gift.
That is mm-hmm. about keeping the intuition open.
Okay.
That is.
So in other words, it's respecting each other.
Right.
I am another version of you. You are another
right.
version of me. Neither one of us are wrong or right. We
right.
both have a unique way of seeing the world, basically.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And the other inner gift is inner strength. So there's definitely strength in this building. There's
mm-hmm.
A lot of energy in it.
Mm.
So and that adds more and more strength.
Mm-hmm.
The other two inner gifts is expression and sensitivity. And so this building also.
Okay, so the last gift is mm-hmm. inner sensitivity?
Expression.
Expression?
Expression and
sensitivity.
Sensitivity.
These are the inner gifts that come with the zero.
The zero.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Inner sensitivity, inner expression, and inner
expression.
Expression and inner
sensitivity. And sensitivity.
Not insensitivity.
Not insensitivity. Insensitivity.
Okay. So what does that mean again?
The expression is about expressing, open up to expressing mm-hmm. oneself, having the ability to do so, and understanding that expression. Communication. Mm-hmm. It is all about communication, is the expression. The sensitivity is being sensitive to everything around, you know, how sensitive we are to things. Mm-hmm. So this building is about expression, and it's also very sensitive towards certain issues.
Wow. So we're living in a pretty cool building. At least you didn't say, ooh, you better get out of this building right now.
No.
That's really cool. That's really, really cool. I like that. Ronda, I think that we're gonna go ahead and break this episode here in a minute, and then we're gonna come back for a chapter two, which will be a separate video, and we're gonna talk about another really interesting thing that you do another time. So I invite everybody at home to stay tuned in or come back and see the second part. But it's been absolutely eye-opening and great talking about numerology. It's something that I'm still trying to wrap my head around how it works, but I would recommend, if you want to look at it from a scientific perspective, there's a book called The Field by Lynn McTaggart, and she talks about how stuff like this works, you know, in this kind of greater sense of a quantum field, like where you know, everything kind of is all happening at the same place in time. Like, you know, Einstein talked about it, Stephen Hawking and guys like that talk about how you know, we're just kind of looking at it with blinders on, and there's like these little clues that are out there that open it up, and numerology seems like it's one of those clues that can be really valuable if someone is you know, willing to look at themselves, really, right? Because it's just would you say that it's just a way of better understanding who we are?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and everyone in our lives. Mm-hmm. It's not an invasion. It's a matter of helping to relate. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, that's what we're here to do, is work together, mm-hmm. because we're not different from each other. Mm-hmm. We're actually all the same.
If somebody wants to reach you to find out more about numerology, like how do they reach you?
Mm-hmm. Through my email. Mm-hmm. My email address. It's rmacneil. Mm-hmm. PS, as in Palm Springs. At yahoo.com.
R. MacNeil, MacNeil.
NEIL.
NEIL, okay. Mm-hmm. At PS.
Yeah, NEILPS at yahoo.com.
Okay. Ronda, thank you so much for coming out to the studio. I really appreciate your time. Thank you. And we are another version of you. This has been The Waking Universe, and happy number finding, I guess. Go home and do your calculations. Thanks.
Thank you.